Of course, the president will be talking about ISIS today with military leaders in Florida after the meeting at the White House yesterday with retired Marine General John Allen, who will be coordinating the worldwide fight against the Islamic State. President Obama will be at Central Command in Tampa today. In Washington, the House, as J.D. mentioned, is expected to vote on the White House's plan to arm Syrian rebels. This comes a day after the president gave the military another mission, ordering thousands of troops to West Africa to help in the fight against Ebola. They'll be building medical facilities and training healthcare workers there. But Dr. Kent Brantley, one of the four Americans who caught Ebola in West Africa, tells a Senate hearing that the worldwide response just has not kept up with this epidemic.
However, has remained sluggish and unacceptably out of step with the scope and the size of the problem that is now before us.
Dr. Brantley also met with the president. He calls the outbreak a national security concern for the U.S. In his words, this is a fire straight from the pit of hell. And today will mark the first meeting of the special House committee investigating the deadly attack on the American diplomatic compound in Benghazi. It's chaired by South Carolina Republican Congressman Trey Gowdy. The committee will focus today on what the Obama administration has done since the attack 2 years ago to improve security at American embassies around the world. And no football for a while for Viking star Adrian Peterson. The teams barred him from all team activities while he faces child abuse charges in Texas. Peterson is accused of using a switch to whip his four-year-old son. And controversy in Washington, D.C. over a T-shirt. You can see it right here. Star Redskin quarterback Robert Griffin III wearing a shirt saying, "No Jesus, no peace." But before he could go to his post-game press conference, he was forced to turn it inside out. The Richmond Times-Dispatch says Griffin had to switch the shirt around because it's not a Nike product, and that breaks NFL rules. Meantime, the manhunt continues in Pennsylvania for the man accused of killing one state trooper and shooting another. The suspect has been identified by police as Eric Frein. He's a survivalist on the run throughout the woods of northeastern Pennsylvania.
He has made statements about wanting to kill law enforcement officers and also to commit mass acts of murder.
Frein is believed to be carrying at least two weapons. He's already facing a long list of charges, including first-degree murder and homicide of a law enforcement officer. State Police Corporal Byron Dixon was killed, and Trooper Alex Douglas is in critical condition after a sniper shot both of them outside a state police barracks. And people in Arizona are prepping for more flooding right now. After last week's severe weather, Tropical Storm Odile is now on the way and is expected to hit sometime tonight. Flash flood watches are in effect now. Thousands of tourists are being evacuated from Mexico as well after Odile roared ashore as a Category 3 hurricane.